OSHA is a regulatory agency created to protect employees from workplace abuses. And in that vein, employers are required to keep records via Forms 300, 300A, and 301 of certain work-related illnesses and injuries. But some serious illnesses and injuries have an additional requirement. Employers are required to report as soon as possible these serious events, any work-related fatalities, inpatient hospitalizations, amputations, or eye loss. Now, if any of these tragic events occur at your workplace, a manager will be required to call the nearest OSHA office, call OSHA's 24-hour hotline, or use OSHA's online form for serious event reporting. In fact, this requirement applies to nearly every industry, even those who aren't normally required to keep records for OSHA. Of course, OSHA has requirements regarding how quickly this reporting must occur. I recommend reporting these serious events as quickly as possible. OSHA requirements state that employers must report fatalities within 8 hours. Furthermore, a fatality that occurs within 30 days of a work-related injury or illness must also be reported to OSHA. When it comes to the other reportable incidents, employers have a little bit more time. Inpatient hospitalizations, amputations, or incidents involving eye loss need to be reported within 24 hours. As I mentioned previously, you can report these serious work injury incidents in three different ways. You can call the nearest OSHA office, you can call the 24-hour OSHA hotline, or you can use the OSHA online form. However, it's essential to note that leaving a voicemail or simply sending an email is not meeting the requirements of this important regulation. If you don't speak to a person when you call your nearest OSHA office, you're required to call back, use the 24-hour hotline, or submit the online form. When you call or get online to report an incident like this, have this information ready. Your business name, the location and time of the work-related incident, the type of serious event, the number of employees involved, the names of the employees involved, the name and phone number of a company contact person, and a brief description of what occurred. Now, like any good rule, there are always exceptions. There are a few of these, so get ready to take some notes. Employers are not required to report serious injuries that result from a motor vehicle accident on a public street or highway, unless the workplace is a construction work zone. If a motor vehicle-related death or serious injury happens at a construction work site, employers must report it to OSHA within the required time frame. Your business or organization isn't required to report serious injuries that occur on an airplane, subway, bus, ferry, streetcar, train, or other commercial or public transportation system. You're also exempt from reporting a death that happens more than 30 days after the work-related event. Likewise, you're exempt from reporting any severe injury, such as hospitalization, amputation, or loss of an eye, if it occurs more than 24 hours after the work-related event. These reporting requirements also don't include any visits to the emergency room if the employee isn't admitted for an inpatient hospitalization. And finally, you aren't required to immediately report inpatient hospitalization for diagnostic or observation purposes only. Only inpatient hospitalization for care or treatment is reported. Now, I must emphasize this. Even if you aren't required to report a serious event to OSHA, these events still need to be recorded for OSHA. For example, if an employee gets stitches at the emergency room following a work-related incident, this event does not need to be reported to OSHA within 24 hours because it's not an inpatient hospitalization or amputation. But if the employer is required to keep records of illnesses and injuries for OSHA, the employee's emergency room trip would need to be added to the 300 log. These requirements can be a bit dizzying, but it's all in the interest of creating a safer, healthier workplace. And if I were to sum up the most important aspects of reporting, it would be these three regulations. In the event of a work-related death, report within 8 hours. In the event of a serious injury, report within 24 hours. And if you're required to, always record any work-related injuries on the appropriate forms.